So let's look at the another operation, that is memory write operation. It's very simple. Suppose we have to perform store R1A, that is the contents of register R1 are to be stored in the memory location at address A specified in the instruction. Now remember, this is instruction. So everything is, all the operand addresses are specified in the instruction itself. So in the first E state, this address field is loaded into memory address register, and the second E state, the contents of the R1 that are to be written on in the memory are loaded in the memory buffer register, and appropriate write commands are given to the memory. And in the third E state, the memory, the appropriate memory location is written from the data that is specified. So we have seen the different execution of different steps in the instruction. The most important thing to note here is that at any point of time or in any T state, we must always remember that only one data can be present at a time on this internal CPU bus. So this is why we have to perform these operations in different T cycles. So this is the basic logic behind it. And if two or more operations don't involve use of internal CPU bus, then they can be performed in the same T cycle. For example, let's look at here the operations of cycle T2 and T3, or T states, T2 and T3 are basically independent of the internal CPU bus. The first one uses the CPU bus to store the data from the R1 to MBR. However, T3 operation is actually concerned with the communication with external memory. So it does not use internal CPU bus. So these two things can be clubbed together. However, here they are written different because anyway, the fetching the data from the external memory is going to take some time. So that is why it is written different and it will not make much of a difference. So while performing the two operations inside the same T state, we have to take care that there is no data conflict present on the internal CPU bus, because only one data can be present at a time on the CPU bus. Okay, so these are the basics of instruction execution operation in CPU organization. Now, next video, we are going to see different micro operations involved and the control signals that control the operations. So please stay tuned. Thank you.